Hi, my name's Jovan and I'm a student at the UTS Animalogic Academy. This is part two of my tutorial series on virtual production using Unreal Engine for very cheap or potentially free. This part of the tutorial focuses on creating free or at least very, very cheap motion capture into Unreal with live capabilities. This video will have timestamps, so if you want to jump ahead or if you miss something, you can do that at your own rate. For this to work, you need a few things to start with. The first is a depth sensor. I use a Kinect from the Xbox Series 1. If you can find them, they're pretty cheap at the moment and they do a good enough job. If you can afford it, there are more expensive options like the Intel RealSense sensors or the Kinect Azure, but I'll be using this Kinect as it works just fine and it's what I have for now. The process should be more or less the same with whichever depth sensor you choose, as long as the software has enabled it. There is a list of compatible depth sensors and cameras on the software's websites, which I'll link below. Now, there are two softwares that can be used. The first is from iPi and the second is from Brekel. Both have paid and free trial versions, so you can try both out and see what you prefer. I personally prefer the Brekel software at the moment, but there are a few kinks and issues in both, which I will explain later on in the video. I'll show you how to use the iPi programs first. However, if you want to use the Brekel Body version 2, then skip forward to this part of the video right here. For the iPi softwares, you need to install iPi Mocap Recorder and iPi Mocap Studio. The recording software is what captures your footage, and the Mocap Studio software analyzes it and rigs it to a skeleton. You might also need to install some drivers, which you'll be prompted to do so when first using the program. These will be necessary to use the Kinect with the software. Once both these programs have been installed and opened, in the iPi Recorder software, select the Kinect and press Record Video. Then, press the Background button and click Evaluate Background. Make sure that it's a still version of your scene, empty from people. Then press record and start recording. You can also set a timer if you want to have the recording begin with you in the frame. This isn't really necessary as you can choose your in and out points later on. It's up to you what you choose. Make sure you start with the T-pose as this will help later on. Once finished, a pop-up will appear where you can rename the file and choose its save location and then send it to Mocap Studio. Once in iPi Mocap Studio, select your height and gender and use the toolbar at the bottom of the screen to adjust your in and out points and then click track forward. And that's pretty much it. There are some cleanup options, including jitter removal, which you can play around with in case there are any issues with your recording, but that's basically the gist of it. Now all you need to do is click record, set target character, so you can put your mocap data onto a pre-rigged character that you have, and they should also preferably be starting with a T-pose. Now you can press play to test that animation and then make sure that the animation's been properly applied onto your rig, and then just press export and export the animation to an FBX or whichever file format you prefer. And that's it, you're done. If there are any issues, then jump back to the point in the timeline where the issue occurs on the little scrubby bar down the bottom and use the cleanup tools on the right hand side of the screen to adjust your mocap tracking data and then just retrack it. You can also live stream this data into Unreal Engine. Now to do this, instead of recording the footage in iPi Recorder, you have to click Start Broadcasting, and then once in your iPi Mocap Studio, press Live and then press Connect, and your mocap data will be streaming right into the iPi Mocap Studio. To then move this into Unreal Engine, in the Export tab, select the UE4 mannequin rig and press Start Streaming. Then open Unreal Engine, go to Plugins, enable Live Link and iPi Mocap Live Link, and then restart to apply. Then open Live Link, go to Source, iPi Mocap Live Link, and match the UDP port number from your Mocap Studio. This will be in the settings button next to the Start Streaming button. Then go back into Unreal Engine, go to the content browser and find the third person AnimBP, which is your animation blueprint. Then in the AnimGraph tab, create a Live Link pose node and connect it to the default pose, unlinking the default node. Select character in the drop-down menu and then press play on your scene. Now you've got live mocap data straight into Unreal Engine. So whichever way you move your body, that'll be applied straight onto the mannequin in Unreal. You can also do a retargeting process with both these softwares, but that will be another step that I'll show you in a later video. Now, for Brekel, the setup process is a lot easier. All you need to do is import the Brekel Skeleton FBX file, which you can find inside the Brekel Source folder on your PC. Then go to Live Link in Unreal Engine, press Message Bus Source, and choose the Brekel character. Create an animation blueprint and attach it to the Live Link like before. Now, if you have multiple characters, you can select each individual animation blueprint, but if it's just one, then just select closest body choice. And that's it. Press play and your Brekel data will be put straight into Unreal Engine. There's also a retargeting process which you can do, which again, I'll show you in a later video. Now, for a quick pros and cons between the two softwares, iPi does require two different programs rather than one, which is a bit of a downside, and its UI looks a little bit older, which I know it's not really a negative, but when you're nitpicking, aesthetics are still a bit important. iPi can also be a little bit more glitchy depending on your internet connection, as you can see in the demo, it's, you know, not as smooth as Brekel is. Now, Brekel does have a more stable connection and a better looking UI, but it can be a little bit more frustrating as well, because in iPi, you can choose the character that you want to be rigged onto and it does it automatically in the software, whereas with Brekel, you need to do your retargeting later on. Now, both softwares are very cheap, only being $250 for iPi and Brekel being $160. So in the end, it's kind of up to you. You can get free trials of both, and I'll leave the links to both of those in the description below. But in the end of the day, it's whichever software fits your needs better. So that's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy this two-part tutorial series into how to get started with virtual production. It's a lot cheaper than traditional means of mocap and camera tracking, and it can get you some pretty cool looking scenes on a budget. I hope that you have fun with this, and if you have anything to show or have any questions to ask, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.